princes of Zion were like girls in a dream.
When our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with shouts of joy, then they said among the nations,
the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad.
Restore our full fortunes, O Lord, like streams in the Negev.
Those who sow in tears shall reap with shouts of joy.
He who goes out weeping, bearing the seed of sowing, shall come home with shouts of joy, bringing the sheaves with him.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The text from the message today is from John chapter 1. John the Baptist had a purpose. His purpose was to prepare the way of the Lord. He was the one who was given to tell the people of Jesus' day that Jesus is coming and there he is. Actually point to him. He was also the one that was given to bring the people to repent of their sins and to give them a baptism for the forgiveness of sins. This is a preparation of the heart that the people needed in order to hear what Jesus would have to say. These are the people who followed Jesus around and heard his teaching and eventually saw him die on a cross and eventually saw him rise from the dead and also saw him alive and ascended into heaven. John's purpose was to prepare the way, to prepare these people, to prepare their hearts to receive the Lord Jesus Christ. Today, your hearts are also being prepared. The Word of God comes to you to prepare you for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ again, to take us home, to live with Him in paradise. And so as the body of Christ, together, we proclaim the coming of Jesus again, knowing that he is coming, and also sharing the word of the forgiveness of sins, which is the ultimate preparation, because we require that kind of cleansing that you received in your baptism, that cleansing you receive as the word of God is preached and proclaimed, and that cleansing that you receive as you receive the very body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. One of the things that I like to do best in anticipation of the Christmas celebration, in preparation for the Christmas celebration, is to set up a nativity scene. I hope that you set up a nativity scene in your home and that you let that nativity scene be a reminder that yes, Jesus has come. He has come and provided for the forgiveness of your sins, but that he is also coming again. And that baby in the manger is the salvation of your soul. Today, the Sunday school kids will help us set up a nativity scene for this service. And the first piece that I want to place is Mary. Mary is the mother of Jesus, and she has a very special place in the history of your salvation. She is the mother of our Savior, and rightly, we here today call her blessed.
Jesus is coming.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will those shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
The second piece that we will place today is Joseph. Joseph's presence in the events around the first Christmas are somewhat reserved. He is, as the betrothed husband, has a special role in Jesus' life, though. He is a protector and a provider. Certainly, Joseph is important in the circumstances leading up to Jesus' birth and even into his childhood through age 12. But we don't hear much about him after that. We do know that Joseph cherished his wife Mary, and he named the baby according to the wishes of the angel who came to him in his dream. He named him Jesus, for he would be the Messiah who would save his people from their sins.
Jesus is coming! Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother, Mary, had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. And her husband, Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife. For that which is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she gave birth to a son, and he called his name Jesus.
That we will place is an angel. The angels do their job, and their job is to bring messages from God to his people in the way that he wants them to. The angels are messengers. The angel Gabriel tells Mary that she is pregnant. An angel tells Joseph in his dream that he should call Jesus, Jesus. And the angels proclaim the birth of Jesus to the shepherds. They know what has happened.
Thank you.
fourth piece that we will place is a shepherd. The shepherds were the first people besides Mary and Joseph to see and to acknowledge the baby Jesus as Lord. They worshiped him because of the message that the angels had given them. When they had finished at the manger, they went out and told everyone what they had seen and heard. The shepherds were, you might say, a foreshadowing of pastors who are given to share the word of God with the people.
Said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby laying in the manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all they have heard and seen, as it has been told to them.
Next, we will place an animal. The animals participated in the scene because Jesus was born in a cave, in a manger, where animals feed. Jesus comes. He comes to live in human form. He comes humble, being laid in a manger. He is a divine king who leaves his throne for a bed of straw where the animals eat.
And while they were there, the time for her came to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Finally, we will place in the manger the baby Jesus. It is amazing to see this image and realize that it is God who was in that manger. It is God who developed in Mary's womb. God who was born, who would grow in stature. God who would teach and preach. God who would die on a cross. God who would pay the price for the sins of the whole world.
And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glorious of only the Son from the Father, full of grace and truth.
And bring you home.
Jesus is coming.
number from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might to be our God forever and ever. Amen."
Given for you. Take, eat. This is the true body of our Lord Jesus.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you, steadfast in the truth of faith, until